Hi, welcome Virgo. How are you beautifuls? This is Gwen. I'm here to do a reading for you for the pink full moon that's happening in a few days. I'm recording this. I don't even know if I can get started like I normally do with your reading. Like, this is crazy how I've prepared for your reading. So I know that there's going a lot. There's going a lot. There's a lot going on in your world, Virgo. It took me forever to prepare to get ready for this reading. Like, I was on a roll doing so many readings. Like, it was just going boom, 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 you know, feeling good, you know, taking breaks in between. But then it came to yours. And actually, it was weird because, like, normally I go through and, like, I like to go in order. Like, how they are, you know, like, and I totally skipped you over. And so there was a message in that, like, when I went to finally sit down and do this, finally, what this energy is, I was like, shit, that was part of the message from Spirit. You have not been looked over, Virgo, for your blessings, for the love, or whatever. Like, you are, like, in this in-between time, in the hard times, you are learning the most about yourself. So be patient, okay? And you have not been looked over. That was a big, big message in this. Because I was like, oh shit, I gotta do Virgos tonight. And then I didn't have the energy to do it when I realized I had skipped you. I had no energy to do it. I was like, oh, okay. And it wasn't like I just needed a snack. No, I needed a whole fucking meal. And I cooked myself something. And you know, like, how when you just cook for you, it's like, I don't know, for me it's tough. I would rather just have some chips, some cookies, and ice cream. No joke. Fruit, whatever. But I needed a meal. Like, I needed to nourish my body. And there's a big message with that, Virgo. To do good for you so that your cup is full, okay? And then I rested, and then I watched TV, and then I smoked a bowl, and I was like, am I ready to do this yet? Nope, still wasn't ready to do it. There ain't no rush in these messages, like, seriously. And so now I think I'm ready, but there's a lot going on. There's a lot going on in your world. A lot of players. I take that however you want, Virgo. A lot of players. A lot of people. A lot of energy around you. And it's young. And it's immature. And it's... So maybe kids. Maybe students. Maybe just inexperienced people. Okay. Yeah, it's the best way that I can describe it. But there's a lot of people in your spread, whereas there have not been in the previous readings. So it's a lot of energies I'm dealing with. So okay, Virgo, take what resonates, throw the rest out. Just to even get to that point seemed like a lot. Like, I seem like there's a lot going on up here for you, Virgo. Let's talk about this full moon. These messages are from the full moon. So that's the 26th of April on to like middle part of May. Okay. In May, we have the 555 portal, which is a major portal of transformation. Okay. Because May 5th, 2021 is 555. Okay. Five, you're all about transformation. And this full moon in Scorpio is all about death, rebirth. Okay? Yeah. Trusting again and having faith the universe has got your back. Releasing control, surrendering. You know, that's this is your rebirth. This is your resurrection. This is your evolution. Virgo. Okay? And, it's time to shed. Full moons are about releasing old ways, shedding an old way, an old programming, an old belief system, an old relationship, an old job, whatever it might be. And with this power of the 5-5 portal and many, there's just like the planets that are transitioning and whatever. It's about unexpected things happening. Truths revealed. Okay? Messages coming. Unexpected blessings. Trust in the divine detours is what I keep hearing. Trust in your gut and your intuition, your heart-centered mind. And your wisdom from past experiences, Virgo. This is a time of transformation and major healing for the sign of Virgo, because the snake come out as the overall message to your reading. And so when I say it's time of transformation, it's shedding the old skin like the snake does, okay? It's time of metamorphosis. This is a card 55. I just talking about the fives for you. This is a huge time for you, Virgo. Time to heal. Time to become one with you again. Your needs, your wants, your happy, your inner child. This is a 10. This is an ending and a new beginning. Don't rush your healing. Don't release constraints of time and also of like how your healing's supposed to look, how the abundance flows to you, what your ideal love partner looks like. Release the past, I hear. Release the past. It's brought you much wisdom, strength, growth. Release the past. Forgive yourself, I hear. Virgo. Okay, so that was snake. Speaks to the Kundalini too, being active and embracing your fears. Or like, you know, like your fear, like fear is valuable too, you know? But we've got to look deeper into our fears. Why are we afraid to make a change? Why are we afraid to embrace the new? Why don't we want to shed this skin? Those kinds of questions, okay? And I finished your spread and then I grounded and centered again. And then I asked if there were any more animals besides the snake want to come out in your reading today. And there were two. It was the dog and the sandpiper. Both very, 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 very playful animals, creatures, spirits, okay? One says be playful, the other says be loyal to what you love. To what you love, Virgo. The sandpiper, he does this little dance. He's like the bird clown. He like runs up to the waves and chases them and dances in the sand. Okay? Get back to what you love. The lotus has already bloomed from the depths. You see the lotus down there. And the dog coming out again with card 19, which is, that's a 10. That's an ending and a new beginning again. I mean, look how many fives you got just right there. Talk about a major transformation. Put on your playful suit. Put on your play suit, Virgo. All right. Beautiful oracle messages from the animals for you, Virgo. And now we've got Matero. Spread here in front of me, and let's look deeper into that. So I'm using my Murder of Crows tarot deck today. It's shadow deck. It's very insightful. First card out, card one. Okay, another new beginning. And I feel like this is you stepping into your own reading, because you are an earth sign and this is the Ace of Pentacles. A brand new job, brand new offer, a brand new, you know, on an exciting new entrepreneurial kind of thing. And you standing in your power and your truth. But you also have, this is how it come out, the Ace of Pentacles. The moon, And then the Lovers. Okay. And the Lovers can speak to the sign of Gemini, a Gemini in your life. But I've got to say, the way that I'm seeing this here and with the clarifying cards that are coming out, when the moon comes out, and now we've got this full moon that I've been talking about too, there's illusion, you know, that, and I said that truths shall be revealed. So, things going on behind the scenes that you may not be aware of. This is a card 18, which is a 9. Coming to the end of the lesson on that. I want to read the moon card to you. Sometimes they have me read out of here and sometimes they don't. But I feel like there's something hidden within the... I mean, because the Lover's card is out too. Within a connection, there's something hidden. Boom. What am I doing? I'm looking for the moon. And I'm looking up here at the Empress. Okay, crazy girl. Come on. Find the moon. The shadows lengthen and grow as the shining orb of the moon rises to its zenith, bathing the waste in a strange silver light. Its expression is inscrutable, revealing nothing, just as its pale illumination casts a weird, otherworldly glow. You look... Sorry, I should have that up for y'all. You look into the eye of a friend and see a complete stranger. There it is. There it is. You look into the eye of a friend and see a complete stranger. And that is in within a relationship. Mm-hmm. This is keywords for the moon. Illusions, messages from instinct and intuition, a journey through darkness, strong psychic information, delusions, and madness. Wow. The Lover's card. I want to read to you about that too, because that's important. I mean, two major arcanas in your spread. Two out of three are major arcanas and a brand new beginning. Seeing behind the illusion is what this full moon and portals are going to help you. You're going to see the truth of the matter within your love connections. At long last, weary of wandering, you see that you are not, in fact, alone on this road. Another soul searches through the strange land for meaning and redemption. The choice is before you, a decision of great consequence. To eat of the fruit of the sacred tree will bring your hearts into alignment, and your paths will join. The dark angel lifts its wings above you both, giving its sincere blessing. Your hand hesitates beneath the branches. Are you ready to bite into the flesh that will erase loneliness and independence? The juice on their lips smells sweet and inviting. Keywords, a chance for union. Draw strength from passion. Find your missing half. Choice between two paths. Companionship and romance and dependence upon another person. It was very key. I had chills when I said, when you look into the eyes of a friend and see a stranger. It happens sometimes in a relationship. When we grow, when we heal, I mean, and it's a time for your healing. You're going to heal even more than you are now. Because remember, I said to release constraints of or visions of what you thought your healing was going to look like. Maybe you thought your healing was going to happen in the same home you got sick. No, it doesn't happen that way sometimes, okay? But you're actually seeing you're seeing the truth in the matter within this relationship and making a choice. Yeah. Okay, so let's get clarifying cards for these. Clarifying the Ace of Pentacles, and here's where all these players come into the mix, okay? And these aren't, I mean... The highest suit I have out here is the Queen of Swords, and that is an air energy around you. Aquarius, Libra, Gemini. Now, Gemini popping out twice here, okay? But the rest are very, they're either messengers or they're young energy around you, okay? So, clarifying the the Page of Pentacles. Excuse me. I almost feel like my words are trapped right now as I'm trying to get my words out. They're held back. Are you holding back your words, Virgo? I literally feel like I've got a burp now or something, like I have air trapped right. Bear with me. I don't have nothing to drink by me. Oh, Yordi. Okay. This energy has been so crazy for y'all. Remember to ground. Grounding is super important for you right now. And to rest. And to take care of you. Remember how I made that whole meal for me and took time out for me. Seriously. You have to take care of your inner child right now before you can take care of anybody else during your healing. It's like you got to mother you. Okay? And you can do it. You can call upon Mother Mary to come in and hold you and send you love and energy, and she will. No joke. We all are connected to the Divine Mother. Okay. So we've got out the Knight of Cups and the Knight of Pentacles, clarifying the Ace of Pentacles. Okay? Two very different knights. Two very different young energies. Okay? Meaning, when I say young energies too, like, they can represent in extremes in nature, extremes in personality. Mm-hmm. So this King of Cups is in love with love. For love's sake. He just loves love. And he's just in love with love and love, love, love. And he pours his heart into everything. Really out without thinking it through. Very emotional this night. Okay. And then this Knight of Pentacles, an earth sign, Capricorn, Taurus, Virgo. It's very methodical. Okay. It's very hardworking. Okay. Detached from his emotions. See the difference? The opposites here almost. Rushing in with their emotions. Detached from the emotions. This is yin and yang energy I'm feeling now. This opposites. But it also could be, you know, just a younger person in your life exemplifying those kinds of traits. And then underneath the moon, under the illusion, is this Queen of Swords and this Page of Cups. And they're both females pictured here. These were both male energies pictured here. In this Wizard's Tarot, it's both, right? Okay, so, and then now we've got the Queen of Swords and the Page of Cups, and the Page of Cups is a feminine energy coming in. This is the highest suit card in your deck. This is the Queen of Swords, okay? Very logic, uses your intuition. Straight to the point, blunt, okay? That's this Queen of Swords. Very good confidant to have. Mm-hmm. Maybe this is where you get some of this trusted psychic advice from this Queen of Swords, this air sign, this Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Help you see beyond the illusion because the owl's there and there's dragons at her. She has a dragon guide. Air dragon, yeah. And then this Page of Cups. Let's read about this Page of Cups. This young, again, energy who is in the water. This page is in the water. And she's got a fish in her hand. So fish speaks to abundance. So a balancing of this person is balancing, like, spending, saving money, maybe? Okay. Keywords, student, curious, enthusiastic, young, inexperienced, emotional, creative, intuitive, and reflective. Sensitive, loving, and creative, the Cups enjoy beauty, art in all forms, and connecting with others. Sometimes they take things too personally, though. Full of curiosity and wonder, this young page immerses herself in whatever she is learning or experiencing. When she commits to something, she is all in all earnestness. She needs guidance in learning to protect her heart without becoming cynical. Immaturity, unrealistic expectations, oversensitivity, and a tendency towards secretiveness can make her hard to deal with. When given a safe place to explore, she will discover the emotional resources needed to mature into a sensitive, caring adult. When given a safe place to mature, okay, she will be able to balance those emotions, her intuition, be able to hear her own intuition. I feel like this Queen of Swords, too, is teaching this student how to deal with her emotional body and her intuition. See how many players are? I mean, I'm not even done with the players in this game. Like, seriously. That's why I'm pointing out the different signs. You in a relationship with kids. The Page of Wands is what clarifies the Lover's card. That is an air sign. Okay, these pages too. This Queen of Swords here too. I got to remember that the pages are messengers. So this is an emotional message that you're receiving. Okay, that's it. From this Queen of Swords, you're receiving a very emotional message. Actually, I see tears. It's because the truth has been revealed. And then the Lovers, what's clarifying the Lovers is this Page of Wands. Oh, I guess I'll have to read about him. He's pretty. I feel like this Page of Wands, this is a message, and this is another message coming. I mean, like messages coming from all directions, I feel. And young energy, and it's crazy and hectic. And when is there time for you, Virgo? This page is all fired up. This is a message. This is a fiery message. It's coming fast. It makes me choke. The message makes me choke. What? Four of Swords. This is how it came out, these two. I'll get to the book here in a minute once I get my breath or whatever's going on with my throat chakra right now. Something's going on with your throat chakra. You're holding back words, I feel. Holding back emotions, holding it back, and it's going to burst like a fucking dam. Excuse my language, but it is. Hold on. So I've got the Four of Swords and the Page of Wands. Okay. Four of Swords, trapped mentally, don't know what to do, but really needing to rest. Spirit like wants to strap you down to a bed and make you rest. That's how I feel there. It's like a chaise lounge. Even better, surrounded by flowers. Fuck yeah. But very much feeling trapped in a situation until this message comes in, too. Let's talk about this message. This Page of Wands comes in fast. Wands are fire suit. Sag, Aries, Leo. Pages are learning about something in a formal setting or as a new experience. Understand what they are going through and you can work with them more efficiently. This is somebody energetic, charismatic, and fond of attention. The Wands are often leaders, Getting things done quickly can lead to taking on too much or not finishing. The young page's bold confidence wants to shine, but his fragile ego gets in the way. He fears looking ridiculous, but wants to jump into every new experience. His energy and instincts are among the greatest assets. When bored, he is edgy, unpredictable, and even dangerous. He needs help curbing his dependence on external validation, his anger, his frustration, and to be blunt, his temper tantrums, in order to mature. Given the opportunity to explore, grow, and shine, he has the potential to be very powerful. But this is somebody very passionate, but also driven by their ego and tends to have temper tantrums and rushes into things and very hot-headed almost, which makes you feel really very much trapped here in this situation. Blessed be. And so that's when I read all of that and all of that was coming out. You know, it was like this, but Spirit says this is a time of transformation and a time for you to heal and a time for you to be playful again and to be loyal to what you love. These two I drew after this, seeing all of this, okay? And the underlying energy, the underlying energy in the shadow deck, I always like to look at that to see what's... It's death. And it's... This card's been coming out a lot in this reading because during this time period, we're dealing with Scorpio. I already told you about that. And it's like, it's death of an old life. And I know it's scary or an old way of being or... You know, but like this ace of... This first card out, this is having enough, a brand new beginning, a brand new job, okay? A brand new fresh start for you, Virgo. And you, it almost feels like you've been blocked this whole time, like you can't get through that window. You know, there's a black angel of darkness there and a crow blocking it, and you can't see your way through the passage, the door, the way out, you know. No, darlings, you can see your way out of that very, very easily, okay? The Nine of Wands next, the Eight of Wands. It's just being, you know, trapped and burdened by other people's expectations. Okay? You have messengers coming in, beautiful, passionate messages coming in. Okay? You got to trust in your own intuition now and do definitely seek out this queen here, this friend. This is somebody more mature, more spiritually sound. Okay? Who can give you trusted advice. Because see beyond the illusion. She's actually teaching you what abundance mindset is all about and how to transmute your emotions and how to know your worth. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna leave it there. I think what was the animal underlying energy? Oh, it's time to collaborate. Card one. It's a brand new beginning. How many more new beginnings I gotta tell you about? Right? And maybe these are just energies too, like these knights coming in that you have options. Have some fun. Be playful. Virgo, dance. Okay. Fill up your own cup first and be loyal to those who love you and who you love, you know? And if something isn't working out and you're feeling trapped, you're feeling like enough's enough in a relationship, where you look at this person and it's no longer there, then it's a time to move on. It's a time to heal. Sometimes it's a time to move on so that you can heal in a different place, because it's so hard to in a place where you got sick to begin with. I had to do it. Mm-hmm. I had to take a major leap of faith. And it was worth it. And I proved to myself what a badass I am, too, that I could start my life over at 45. Okay? I love you, Virgo. Full moon blessings to you, my darlings, okay? I wish you nothing but beautiful love and blessings and miracles and all the abundance, okay? Showering it upon you. Mwah. Take care of your heart first. All right. I love you guys. If it resonated, give me a thumbs up, comment below, share these videos, donate to our channel. All those things help us so very much, and we love you for it.